Hi, Andrew Valko here, and welcome to the Power Labs of Ametek PDS. If you know anything about our business, we specialize in aerospace-grade solid-state power control, and that includes wire protection. As you move to solid-state control, there are a number of advantages. Automated control of loads, system wire weight savings, monitoring of load health, and removing a lot of the clutter from the circuit breakers from the cockpit by consolidating all the control to pages on a multifunction display. But one of the big and key advantages of solid state is the switching speed and the ability to quickly interrupt a wire fault. Today we're going to do a quick demonstration that shows the speed advantages of solid state technology and the benefits it provides in terms of minimizing collateral damage to both the wire bundle and the aircraft. To do this, we've constructed a small experiment where we're going to compare the reaction of a standard MS3302 circuit breaker to an Ametek solid-state power controller when a parallel arc fault occurs on its load line. Okay, so before we get started, let's just take a review of the setup here. What I have here is a 30 kilowatt power supply. It's providing three-phase AC, 115, 400 hertz. We're gonna steal one of the phases here, and we're gonna run it through a traditional MS3320 10 amp circuit breaker. And what we're doing for the parallel fault test is we're using 22 gauge Teflon wire. We have the live wire coming in connected to a razor blade. And then we have a ground wire underneath the razor blade. We're gonna lower the guillotine. This is per SAE spec AS5692. We're basically gonna lower the guillotine and keep striking the wire, keep creating shorts until we get this thermal breaker to pop. So we're gonna see what its performance is like here. So to help me out with that, I'm gonna bring in the system engineer for our AC SPDU, Don Murray. So he's gonna be our victim for the thermal breaker, and I'm gonna step away while Don mans the guillotine.
Thanks
and
a lot.
We'll capture the performance of the thermal breaker. I've now turned on the power supply, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna do successive arcs until we can get the 10 amp circuit breaker to trip. So Don, since we know the circuit breaker is gonna have a hard time tripping, go ahead and work your way down the blade. That's pretty bad. Whoa. Now you can see he has to feed the wire through continually. Oh, we basically torched the blade. The circuit breaker tripped. So it took about four or five of those until we got the actual thing to trip. And go ahead and take a look at that blade.
Five.
We've destroyed the wire, but we've vaporized the sharp end of that blade pretty well. Gives you a really good demonstration about how long. We're looking at 500 amp current peaks, looking at this scope, multiple 500 amp spikes. Remember, this is AC, so it crosses zero every once in a while. So the thermal breaker gets some benefit of the voltage crossing zero, but still, it took at least five of those damaging strikes. You can think of the collateral damage you would do to, say, a wire bundle or maybe even parts of the airframe. Or even if that wire bundle was running against a hydraulic line, imagine what you'd do to the wall of that tubing. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna cut away and repeat this test, but we're gonna hook up a solid-state power controller, and we'll take a look at how the solid-state power controller can perform with this same exact setup. What we've done now is we've converted this setup over to now using the Ametek AC SPDU. This is a 24 channel box capable of delivering 180 amps continuous, three phases, so it's basically 60 amps per phase. We're going to take one of those channels on a phase, and we're going to replace this thermal breaker and perform the exact same guillotine arc testing, and show you how it performs with the same razor blade and what its response time is. Okay, so I'm gonna have Don do the honors again. Again, this is something you shouldn't do at home, but I think this is gonna be a lot safer than the thermal breaker. Don, whenever you're ready. Okay, so Don finished that up. You saw that the first time he got the snap of the fault, and then the second time cut the wire in half, showing that there was not another fault. And that's because the SSPC responded the very first time and was able to basically open up that circuit. And you'll notice the thermal breaker didn't open at all during that event, even though it was in series with the SSPC. The other thing that's really interesting to note is the amount of damage done to the blade is significantly less, basically because we're interrupting that curve. It was actually within a partial cycle of an AC waveform. So we really limited the amount of energy that due to the arc. Okay, so we've pulled the razor blades out, and you can see this top blade here. This is the thermal breaker. You can see the five different hits, how it vaporized basically the edge of the blade. And here is the one shot on the AC SPDU. You can notice a dramatic difference in terms of the amount of damage done to the blade and the fact that the SSPC tripped the first time. So this demonstration gives a really good contrast between a thermal-mechanical breaker and a solid-state power controller that relies on a shunt to measure current. You can see there's significantly less damage when a solid-state power controller is measuring current in microsecond intervals and is able to basically interrupt the fault before significant damage is done. So if you've enjoyed this video, give us a thumbs up. For more videos, like or subscribe to our channel and visit us at ametekpds.com. Thanks.